This is a Roland System 1M attached to a little sequencer I made in Pure Data, and I want to show you something about how the envelopes work. So we'll set the velocity to around 100 in MIDI CC speak, and on we go. At this point, all I'm doing is playing a triangle wave, filter is wide open, amp has a long release, and it's a little crackly there, but you know, I'm not so worried about this little pop as much as I am other effects. So, let's make the velocity a little more human, like you would play it on a keyboard. Your velocity values are going to vary. And I think the pops are a lot more present. If you were playing a portamento lead, you would probably not want that stuff. Back to the consistent velocity value. And I think the difference there is pretty obvious. So, this has a mono mode, a unison mode, and a poly mode. Let's do the unison mode. This sounds okay at a consistent velocity, but before, let's make it a little more human and see what happens. I think the clicks make the unison mode pretty dislikable if you're playing from an external MIDI keyboard. So, on we go to poly mode. I'll make the velocity more robotic again, and turn the portamento off, because the portamento picks one note, and we're just running essentially a one-note sequence. I actually like the oscillators a lot, and it's nice to think of this in poly mode, four voice poly mode, as something that you could play pads with. However, I think the pops here are pretty hard to take as useful in service to something soft and pad-like. So, that doesn't work very well. Given that this is just a computer program with a bunch of knobs attached to it, I would expect that Roland could fix this behavior, which is a little dumb.